Hello dear students, I am Tosavanga Dwan, teacher educator, government elementary teacher education institution, Puri Garia, Balasu. I welcome all of you to this online digital class and I congratulate you as you got promotion to the second year. And in this class, in this class, we will start our second year courses. And here I will discuss with you about the PC2 book. There is a book in second year, PC2, and it is about the English teaching. How we can teach English to the primary level students, we will learn in it and we will apply that in the classroom when we deal with the students. So, the first unit, we will start the first unit. The name of the first unit is Post-Text Content Analysis. So, teaching and learning English is a challenge for the teacher, and it is more challenging when the teacher is going to teach the primary level students, because the primary level students, they are coming from different background, diverse background. When teacher face those students with different background, they also face problem of introducing English as a second language for them. And students also face problem because they are coming from their mother tongue background, and a huge amount of mother tongue is present in their mind. They are practically use that mother tongue in different activities when they are talking with their friends, talking with their parents, talking with the other persons. They use their mother tongue very easily, fluently. But when we talk about the English language, or learning English language, they face some problems. We use a different English language in our surroundings. It is clear. We in our daily life, we use a huge amount of English language, but we don't know that these are the English language. As a English language, we are not using that. We think that these are a part of our mother tongue, and we are practical with that. So, for example, boss, truck, pepper, police, glass. We daily use these words. A illiterate person also use these words. They don't know that these are the English word, but they use these words as their mother tongue. So here we will discuss about the sounds, vocabulary, structures and uses of English language remain confused the students as they are fluent in their mother tongue. So there is confusion in using the English language or mother tongue language. They often confuse the sound, structure and usage of English language with their respective mother tongues. So teacher must give attention to this. Teacher must understand these aspects where the students face problems in using the English words which are not in use, not in practical use, and not easily available in their surroundings. Some English words, maximum English words are not easily available in our surrounding, but some are available. Keeping in view the above problems, the confusion regarding the English words with the mother tongues and the sounds, its structure, vocabulary, all these problems. So keeping all these problems, the textbooks in English language have been carefully prepared for the students with sufficient amount of learning activities and exercises. Sufficient amount of learning activities and exercises are given in the textbooks prepared for the primary level students. And topics selected are also contained interesting materials to motivate the students. To motivate the students, the topics which are collected by the textbooks, by the book prepare some time, also given most important effect, that interesting materials are selected for the students so that teacher can easily motivate them. While preparation of the textbooks, it is also given high important the interest level of the students. Topics which are interesting for the students of that level, that are selected, giving local attention, local example, all these things. So interesting topics are selected for the students for motivating them. And very important thing is here that textbooks is referred very effectively, containing different exercises and activities, interesting materials. But this transaction is very essential. If the teacher do not transact it in a proper way, then students will face problem, and he also has problem while dealing with the students. So textbook transaction is very important for the teacher. Transaction of the textbook is very important as the intended learning outcomes, such as acquisition of skills, acquisition of language skills, vocabulary, structure and usage, depend upon the quality of transaction. So textbook transaction is very important while we are talking about the learning of English language for the primary level students. The major role is here the teacher. Teacher play a major role. He or she transact the textbooks in a proper way, he can easily motivate the student to learn this new language, the English language. So the outcomes which we are talking, the language skills, structure, vocabulary, all these things, acquisition of all these things depends on the quality of transaction. So teacher must be effective, must be trained to transact the textbooks before going to the classroom. So as language learning depend on practical use of the language. Language learning depend on the practical use of the language. So students must be practically use the language, must practically use the language. Only theoretical knowledge is not sufficient. Teacher must practically use the language. So various language activities must be done by the teacher with the students. Learner have to play a more active role by participating in the language activities. In order to realize the aim of teaching learning English, teacher must teacher should understand the organization of the text in the textbooks. So some major points must be remembered by the student teacher, that they must understand the organization of the text in the textbooks. They must understand the organization of text. They must identify the learning components or learning items in the text or in the topics. They must be able to identify the learning components or learning items. Then they decide the learning outcome. They must be able to decide the learning outcomes. What major changes will occur after discussion or after going through this topic? Teacher must decide them and design the learning activities for the learner. At last, teacher must be able to design the learning activities of the learning activities for the learner. So these points must be remembered by the teacher. They must understand the organization of the text in the textbooks. They must identify the learning components. Then they must decide the learning outcomes. They must design the learning activities, actual learning activities for the student. This would automatically help the teacher in the preparation of lesson plan. If the teachers are able to do all these activities, then they can easily prepare a lesson plan of a topic, lesson plan for each class or period. So in this unit we will discuss about the content analysis and many more activities here. So before going through this unit detail, you must understand the objectives of this unit. What are the objectives of this unit? You must understand this. After completion of this unit, you will be able to make a content analysis of the text. After completion of this unit, effectively, the teacher will be able to make a content analysis of the text. They must identify the language items intended in the intended for learning. Teacher will be able to identify the language items intended for learning. They must be able to design the learning activities for transaction. What are the activities which they are going to transact with the students in the classroom, they must be able to identify or design that learning activities. Then use the content analysis for developing a lesson plan. Use the content analysis for developing lesson plan. So measure focuses lesson planning. So in developing lesson plan, content analysis is very useful. So if the students are unable to analyze the content, they cannot be able to prepare a effective or good lesson plan. So content analysis is very important for the teacher of English. So dear students, in this class we have discussed some amount. In the next class we will discuss other aspects of English. So very very thanks to all of you for watching this video. Stay home, stay blessed, and rise of your knowledge, raise your knowledge, and prepare in your home for the next time. Continue your study at home without hesitation. Collect different sources. Be active, energetic. Thank you.